Joey, you get your three wins now. You're right up there with you were talking about that the other day, weren't you?
Yes, we were.
Right up there now with four other drivers with three wins, with two to go before we set the chase field. And certainly like to hear your thoughts about winning at Bristol. Certainly this is it's got to be a big one for you.
It's a really big one. You know, I feel like the Bristol night race is maybe the third or fourth biggest race of the year. Just the atmosphere before the race. I mean, if it doesn't pump you up, nothing does. It's just the baddest mamma jamma racetrack ever built. It's so much fun to go around, and you got to hustle the car so hard, and something we don't typically have. We talked a little bit about it the other day when I was in here about how hard you had to drive the car, and wondering if it was going to be like that in the race. And yes, we had to drive the car that hard in the race to go fast, and it means a lot to be able to get this victory. And obviously Penske with the 1-2 finish there, and all three of Team Penske drivers being able to get a win with Brad in a truck, and then Ryan last night, and then ourselves trying to put the cherry on the top here in a cup race. So it's just all of us got a win. Everyone's happy. So definitely a very special weekend for Team Penske to be able to do that, and for Ford. And right now the momentum we have and the cars that we have, we've been fast at every type of racetrack. And I wish we were in Atlanta tomorrow. Well, maybe not tomorrow. I'm going to enjoy tomorrow, but Monday sounds good.
And Todd, congratulations. Certainly this race team is showing that it's championship form. And you guys have really been putting together some excellent runs here of late, but got that win here tonight at Bristol. Huge crowd. This had to be a big win for you as a crew chief.
Definitely. It's the epitome of short track racing, right? It's especially the way the new tire, tire change that we had, and what it did to the racetrack and rubbered up so hard. You had to perform on, you had to execute at every level. We've had good race cars here through every race Joey and I have been here together, and we haven't executed at every level. But we got an opportunity to do that today, and just a phenomenal place to race, and brings you back to the roots of where you came from, where you're going to rub on people a little bit, and you run hard, and Joey did a phenomenal job of it tonight, and this whole race team's definitely building momentum right now, and in the right time, I believe.
And Walt, certainly a big weekend for Team Penske. 1-2 finish here tonight. Both of your drivers are secured into the chase. Both have three wins. Both are going to be championship contenders. Just talk about how the organization feels about all this at this time.
Well, thank you. Thanks, Kerry. I think that it was important. Mike Nelson and I had a little conversation tonight before the start of the race, and I said to Michael, who's the general manager of our program, I said, I think it's really important that we continue the momentum that we have. I said it would be great to win one of these last three races before the chase, not to back off and just keep the pressure on. And Joey certainly demonstrated that tonight, as did Brad. And I think it illustrated again the place where we are right now in preparation for the chase.
Excellent. It's going to be quite the chase. But let's take questions now for this race-winning team. If you have one, raise your hand. Start right over here to the left. Kenny Bruce, far left.
Kenny Bruce with NASCAR.com. Joey, when you're trying to run Matt down, you look in your mirror and you've got Brad all over your back bumper. How much of a distraction was that for you?
It's not a distraction. It's just something you have to put into the equation of when you're catching him. I wanted to make sure I had enough room behind me for if I made that pass and didn't succeed and make that pass, I had a hole to get back in, and I wasn't going back to third because obviously second's a disadvantage on the restart, but third's even worse. So I wanted to make sure I definitely stayed in front of third. So I just kind of hounded him for a while and waited for that mistake and waited for that golden opportunity where I knew I can clear him. So I waited and waited, hoping there wasn't a restart because I was going to be in trouble. But finally, he got a little bit up in the rubber. Up high, and he got a little free, and I got a good run at the same time. I was able to get up underneath him and get some good position into the corner and slide up. And it took patience, you know, because if I didn't do it, I was going to go back to third, and that kind of takes your shot at winning away. So that's the way we had the race all night. It's just kind of look at how far behind the car is behind you, wait for lap traffic, and capitalize then.
Let's go to the press box for questions. Go ahead, press box.
ESPN.com. Joey, Brad just said a while ago that he thought this was the most grueling race of the year. Do you agree with that? And also, yeah. Do you think your youth served you a little well for a physically and mentally demanding race like that?
Yeah, I mean, I made it, but it definitely was a very, very tough race. I feel like it's the most physically demanding racetrack, not only for the driver, but for the race car. You know, you think about the loads these things are on, it's never really a break. You know, you're just always on the gas or the brake or in the turn. It's just, there's always something going on. And as a driver, you don't get a break inside the race car either. So a few times the caution comes out and you're like, thank God. And then you're going green like a minute and a half later. You're like, what the heck? So, you know, it definitely was a tough race. That's why we all train and try to be in the best shape we can to, you know, get through it. But, you know, anyone says we're not athletes, I disagree with that, especially today. It's just such a, you got to be able to focus so hard and drive your car so hard up against the wall. And, you know, one mistake takes you out of this thing. So the focus you got to have and, you know, obviously like we were just talking about, the thought process you have to have when you're trying to pass cars and trying to communicate with your crew chief. It's just a lot of things going on at the very small racetrack when you're making 15-second laps. So it's definitely a very tough racetrack for sure. That's what it means so much to win here.
Go ahead, press box. Let's stay up there.
Joey, Chris Knight, CatchFans.com. Do you feel like that you're maybe flying under the radar as far as this championship is concerned? And do you feel like that you could maybe be a surprise attack on the veterans going into the championship? And do you feel like that they kind of underestimate you going not only into Richmond, but all the way through the chase?
I don't care what they think of us. We're going to do what we got to do. They can underestimate us. They can overestimate us. I don't really care. We're going to go out there and do the best we can, do what we've been doing. Ty Gordon and myself have been, you know, working very good together and communicating a lot with our race car. And we really understand what we need to race well. And that's the way we practice. And it shows up when it comes game time in the race. So we're going to keep doing that. They can think whatever they want to think, but I know inside this 22 team, this whole 22 team feels like we're contenders to win this championship. And, you know, I mean, it'd be really weird if we didn't think we were. We got 3 wins right now. We got a really good shot. We've been fast at every single racetrack. And that's because this whole 22 team and all of Team Penske, but in particular, is 22 teams always looking for that next bit. And no one's just doing their job and say, I did my job and that's enough. They're always looking for that extra little bit. And how they can become better and how they can make our race car better. And that's what it takes. So it's definitely the best shot I've ever had at winning a championship. I can promise you that. So I feel very confident going into it.
What would it mean for you to win the championship for Ford?
It'd mean a lot. that's kind of a dumb question. Of course it's going to mean a lot. It's such a winning the championship's the biggest thing you can do in this sport. So and doing it for Ford, yeah. Doing it for Team Penske, doing it for everybody, you know. It's a lot of pressure when you go into it, but we're a team. We do it together.
Any other questions upstairs? Back downstairs. Questions for Walt, Joey, or Todd? Right here, Matt, and then Bob, and then Stan.
Matt Weaver, PopularSpeed.com. Joey, we saw this year more than the previous years past, guys having to run the top. Only one or two guys can make the bottom work. Jamie was really the only guy who could consistently make the bottom work. Eric Almirola mentioned earlier that maybe the track could consider grinding the bottom like they had the top to open that bottom lane back up. Any thoughts about that?
You know, it's very hard to be able to do it, right? Because, you know, now the top's coming so well. But at the same time, it does produce a pretty good race. You know, it's kind of like the old Bristol. Everyone was on the bottom, and you had to kind of root and gouge to get people out of the way. Well, it's the same thing, but up top, you know? So it's definitely... you know, it's different but similar, and I think it puts on a good race. And I think the fact that, you know, some of the lap cars are a little bit slower, that's your opportunity to pass, right? So when you can pin a guy and stuff like that, that's your shot. You know, for us, we had a pretty good car that we were able to, you know, make passes throughout the day. But you know, on restarts, you have a few laps of trying to make the bottom work, then you have to find a hole to get back up top and just kind of let your car come to you, and then, you know, wait for that opportunity to pass somebody. But we knew that going into it, so it's not very frustrating as it for a driver. And like I said, my car was good, so that probably keeps me from getting too frustrated also. But I feel like it was a good race tonight. I felt like there was some good passing. There was some good strategy going on. No, I wasn't too concerned. I was didn't really think about it. I was just thinking about how I can have the best restart I can and make something happen out of this. I felt like I was in good position. You know, Todd gave me four tires there, and you know, pit crew did a great job on keeping our track position, and you know, with a restart sixth, that's better than fifth, and made sure I had a good start there, pass as many cars off the get-go as I can, and then settle in and then start working on the 20. But I was impressed how well the 20 hung in there on old tires like that. You know, seen guys with two tires tonight that eventually would fall off towards the end of the run quite a bit, and man, he kind of hung in there pretty well, so he had a pretty fast race car.
Go Stan, Hank, Seth, and then Jay. Go ahead, Stan.
Stan Creekmore with RPMtonight.com. Joey, have you even had a brief thought about the fact that you now have two attempts to lead everybody into the chase? Mm-hmm. And at the same time, do you believe that your teammate will be your biggest challenge in the chase?
Well, I haven't thought about it yet, but as far as getting that next win, but I do feel like Atlanta is a good racetrack for us, a place we were very, very fast. Probably the best race car I ever had was last year in Atlanta, so very, very excited about going back over there. So that'll be fun. But, you know, really, you know, leading them into the chase does mean something. You know, that's pretty cool, but if we're able to do that, but I'd much rather lead him at Homestead and do it that way. But I do feel like Brad is going to be one of the top contenders to win this championship along with us and the guys that you see tough out there. But you never know. I mean, you've seen it. I know it's a different chase format than normal, but you've seen guys that, you know, kind of run so-so, and then all of a sudden the chase starts and they pick it up a notch, and all of a sudden they're, you know, kicking butt.
Into being a Sprint Cup driver and just mature and all that stuff.
I think everybody at Team Penske does an awesome job preparing good race cars. I think that shows with a 1-2 finish tonight. But you can't do anything with great race cars unless you got great talent behind the wheel. I think as our years have gone, as our second year has gone on, Joey alluded to this earlier, but understand what we have to have in practice to be successful come race time. And I feel like that's something that's separated this year from last year. We know the balance we're looking for. We know what we're looking for, and we're not necessarily the fastest car in practice. But and that was true. That was true here. We battled through practice and did a lot of things, but we got to the end of it. And I think lap average, we were 11th or 12th in the first practice. And you know, we looked at what we had, but we had what the car was driving the way that we needed to drive to be successful come race time. And I think that showed. I think that showed tonight that. When we got to lap traffic, we could really hustle through it. So to your original question of believe that we can be successful and isn't pulling the rope together. And that's that I think is what helps us, you know, to have speed every week. And I think we'll continue to build off that.
Let's go to Seth and then to Jay. Go ahead.
Seth Livingstone, NASCAR News Service. I'll ask Walt this. Compared to preseason, how would you sum up the dynamics in your shop right now with a young driver that's already won a championship and a young driver that's come on like crazy this year? Where do you think you guys are at compared to where you expected to be at?
I think we're probably, candidly, we knew we'd have a good team this year because if you recall, coming off the championship, we were going through some significant changes. Think about it. We switched from one manufacturer to Ford. That was a big enough change. There was a rules change, so we were starting with a new car. We had a new driver join the team. We had in the performance of the team this year with six wins. And when we think about it, we might have even had one or two more along the way. So I think that's probably a fair assessment. What do you guys think? What do you think, Joey?
I agree. Okay. That's a good answer.
Let's go over here to Jay, and then we'll go to Steve and then Jim.
Jay Pennell with Fox Sports. Kind of following up on that, you know, it's you guys talk about the chemistry you guys have as an organization, not just the 22 team. But when it comes down to it, you're going to have to battle Brad in the for the championship. How do you approach that dynamic of working together as an organization, but also, I mean, you're going to have to beat one another. There can't be two champions in this deal.
Who's that for?
Yeah.
Either you or all of us. Well, I think, you know, at least from the driver standpoint, I think both Brad and myself understand that we need to work together to be able to run well, right? We're a two-car team out there. We need to work very tight together to make it work. And I think that's the same throughout all of Team Penske. You see that all the way through. But we have to make sure, as a driver, it's our responsibilities right now to make sure we race each other right, make sure we still share our information. Because it's the moment we stop doing that and the moment we grow away from each other, the performance will go away. I think we both understand that, that if we grow apart from each other, we're not going to be running first and second anymore. We're going to be racing for 15th and 16th, and we don't want that, you know. And you know, Brad says it all the time. I say it too. I'd much rather finish second to Brad and beat him and finish 14th. You know what I mean? And that's the attitude we got to keep throughout this whole thing. And yeah, I see ourselves racing for the championship, and I see that that becoming tough. But I think you know, we're aware of what we need to do to go fast every week, and we'll keep that throughout everybody.
Let's go over to Steve Richards, back in the back right.
Joey, this is Steve Richards of PRN, down here in the peanut gallery.
Hey.
quick question. What were you thinking when you crossed the checkered flag to your first win at Bristol, and what does having the Bristol trophy mean to you?
You know, when you come across the line for a win like that, and such a big win here at Bristol, probably the biggest win of my career, I'm kind of at a loss for words. I just scream. You know, there's just so much raw emotion that comes out of nowhere. You know, it's just you know, the last 40 laps, you're waiting for the caution, you're waiting for something. Brad's catching me. You're just so intense, and managed to come across that line and get that checkered flag. I don't have words I can put that into, that I can put that into. It's just the raw emotion of winning one of these races is unreal, because you work so hard. You know, you dedicate your life to winning a Sprint Cup championship and winning races, and that's not just for the driver, that's for everybody. I'm sure Todd must have the same emotions, I would think, and it just, like I said, you put everything you got into this, and when you succeed, it's awesome, because you're not racing against Joe Blow out there. You're racing against the best race car drivers out there and the best race teams out there. And when you're able to beat them, you should be pretty proud of yourself.
Jim Utter had a question, and then Dustin up here on the front.
Jim Utter, Charlotte Observer. Obviously, best season of your career. It's not even close to being done yet. Whatever your worst day was at Gibbs, whatever day that was, did you... Could you still envision a season like this? And when you came to Team Penske, what was your confidence like, and how soon after arriving did you might be an important call?
FERP.
How soon after arriving did that change or improve?
You know, my worst days over there. I think about it. You know, and obviously. Just like anybody, you'd be down in dumps, right? And you lose your confidence as a driver, and that's probably the worst thing that can happen, is when you lose your confidence. And yeah, I was in that boat, you know. And thank goodness I had nationwide races, and we were kicking butt nationwide, because that's really what I had to rely on, is to go up there and win those things, and that would you know, help me just get through it. And it was really, really hard. And yeah, to answer your question, no, I would never think that I'd have a year like this at that point. You know, and that's why, you know, the mental side of this is just as important as the physical side. You got to have your head in the right spot. And but I'm happy I went through all that. You know, it's made me who I am now, and you know, it's made me aware of how I have to mentally be to win these things. And going through the tough times, you never appreciate the good times. And you know, and obviously there's a lot of good times over there. Don't get me wrong. You know, and. Obviously the last year over there, able to win a race and all that, that was good for me. You know, that's probably the big moment that was able to get me this right, you know. And who would ever think that? I mean, I felt like, you know, when I came over here at Team Penske, is I don't know what my goals were. I think it was just kind of like, hey, just pick it up a notch in every single area. whether that's on or off the racetrack. And you get to walk in there as a new person, you know, be who you want to be, you know. And for me, it was kind of that moment I grew
up. For Joey, and Todd may be able to answer this as well, how did last year at this point leading into the chase, what did you learn about preparing for the chase, last year's chase experience, that helps you better prepare for this period, getting ready for the chase? And for what you've got to go through in the chase. How did last year's experience, obviously we get better with age, we get better with experience. How has it helped you get ready for the chase and then get ready to make that next step up? Obviously you had a good bit of success last year, but obviously to win it, you've got to take another step. So how have you done it? And maybe what have you seen out of how he's kind of approached things maybe a little bit differently this time around?
Oh, you go.
I've been talking a lot. You talk.
I would say, you know, that you've got to experience it first to understand how to prepare for it. And that was probably the thing that I would take from last year is, at this point last year, we weren't locked in. We were racing. We had a win, but we were still right at that verge of points and didn't know where we'd be and racing people for that. For those wild card spots with points, and whether we'd be in on points, whether we'd be in on a win, and all that. So there was still a lot of stress at this point of just trying to get in. In this race, we overcame a lot, came back from having to pit with 40 or 50 to go for debris on the nose, and Joey drove his off, and he rated G today. We drove back to fifth, and it was a good thing for us. But we had to focus on Atlanta. We had to focus on Richmond and what we could do to make sure we were in it. And you couldn't do any preparation. We weren't as prepared how to go forward because we didn't know what to expect. I think the bigger picture now is you've seen it. We know we're in. We started conversations when we won Texas of, okay, how do we best prepare for the 10 race grind and the new format. And I think the new format brings a whole new picture to what you've got to do and how you need to race each segment to be successful and trying to break that down. And then we've got a good plan going forward of how Team Penske is going to test for this chase. And those plans are already laid in stone and going forward, and we're just trying to execute them. So, last year let us know what we needed to do, and then the success early in the season kind of let the stress level come down and say, okay, what do we got to do going forward? And it's really changed how we are going to race, the next two races as well. You want to be successful as much as you can, but you also want to make sure that you keep your head on the big picture. You got to keep momentum with the race team because there's a lot of that right now, and momentum going forward, but we still need to make sure we maximize our opportunity at every racetrack in the chase.
No, and we talk about that a lot, and I talk about that a lot, but everyone just goes harder, and you think, right now I feel like I'm going as hard as I possibly can. It's like I got nothing else left in the tank, but when the championship's on the line, there's some more left in there, and it's my job to find what's left inside of me when, it comes 2 weeks down the road here when we get to Chicago. That's the moment I got to find, where is there a little bit left? Where can I become a little bit better? And that's my part, but the team needs to do the same thing. Everyone needs to do the same thing to be able to race these guys. And, we think we're running all out right now, but there's always something left. There's always something left that you got more in the tank. And, we just got to find it and do it.
Are you surprised how much you were able to step up in the chase last year?
We were fast. We were able to step it up a little bit, maybe not as much as we would like. We battled some adversity throughout the chase, but for the most part, we ran pretty good. I feel a lot better about our chances this year, though, already.